Hey tubers, Big Kid here, archersfriend.com, bigkidreviews.com, and many more. Got a little problem here. Gonna see what I can do with a little redneck ingenuity. Some time ago I did a review on this hall safe remote or wireless backup camera. Had a nice display on it. Infrared for night, supposed to have an effective range of somewhere around 300 feet. I don't think that'll ever happen, or 200 and something feet. No obstructions maybe, but it's very, very good enough for backing up to a trailer or gooseneck or fifth wheel or something like that, or even maybe seeing how how you're doing backing up a trailer where your mirrors, when you jackknife, won't show. Did that for the camper for a while. Had this a few years and carried it in this bag in my pickup. And after thousands and thousands of miles of rattling around in there, I needed to use it. So I dug it out. Well, I got a new truck, so I was cleaning the old one out and found it and remembered it being in there. And went to charge it up. And as you can see, the little tip that goes here, and there's a fuse, this right here goes in there, spring loaded, and then it has a little, your little cap such as this over that fuse, and somehow it's contained in here, but the little black retainer thing has cracked or broke or whatever and spit the part out. Now this is a 12 volt to 24 volt in, but it's a 5 volt DC output on a 3.5 millimeter jack. And then there's a splitter that allows you to charge both of these up at the same time. Both of these have rechargeable batteries in them. Well, you can't charge it because the center gizmo is broke, so you don't get any power. Now, in days gone by, you go down to your local Radio Shack and find an adapter kit or a power supply or anything that you needed to either replace this or rebuild it, but not anymore. Radio Shack has turned to a cell phone trinket store with 30,000 pieces of nickel plastic that they get $2, $3, $4, $10 a piece for. And while I was at one of the local ones yesterday, one of the customers was wondering if that store was going to close because so many of them had. And the clerk says, oh no, not them, it was just the ones not making any money. And I reminded him that the reason Radio Shack, Tandy Corporation has been going downhill for years is they quit dancing with who brung them. The hobbyists made them what they were with a craft shop on the leather side of Tandy, and on the Radio Shack side, the home builder, kit builders, and repair technicians, and it's all changed. It's just, you can't buy parts there. The clerks don't know anything about electronics anymore. It's just kind of like going to a parts house. If you can't tell them what it came off of and give them the exact description, well, their computer can't find it, and the clerks don't know anything about electronics. Now here was one problem that could be an issue that I found, and looking at the, I hope this focuses it, I can't see it on the camera, but if you look at the pinout here, it's trying to tell you, besides being made in China, it's just not going to focus. But it's showing the center pin as the positive, which is completely bass-ackwards from any of the other plugs I've ever tested. And since this one is broke, I can't really check it with a VOM. But I'm going to take this apart and see if there's some way with, I've got a few parts and pieces here, and see if I can reconstruct something that will retain that, and maybe get back in business. This is an old snap cap that broke for a 9mm, and I've got an empty 22 long rifle brass, and here's a 9 brass, and here's a 17 H2 unfired round. I'm just going to play around a little bit and see if I can reconstruct something that will work, and I'll be back later when I get something else figured out. Alright, we're back, and I got this apart with a little coaxing from a Swiss Army knife and some very thin screwdrivers. And this center one has got the red, so that's still telling me, well, you know, the cigarette and cigar lighters, that center portion is the positive on the vehicle. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. And this white one is going to the ground, which is the big part of your cigarette lighter socket. Now, the problem is, when it's apart and I check to see where I get resistance, it reverses somehow on this pin, and the center is now showing the plus. So when I check the resistance across from this red spring to the center, I get nothing. But if I go to the outside shroud, or the outside, which normally is the ground on all these other plugs, then that is the one that has now become hot. So they've got the cameras wired in reverse, I guess, to make it proprietary. And maybe while they're no longer in business, because I can't find anything about this brand at all anywhere, and they probably got a lawsuit or something going. So as a result of that, what I'm going to try to do is to take this circuit board, which is changes your 12 volt DC to your 5 volt DC, but it also changes the polarity on this plug some kind of way. So if I can get this rigged up to, say, a regular plug. Now this is just 12 volt to 12 volt, but of course it has a great big plug on it. See where in the world the other end of it went. There it is. It's much larger than the 3.5. Now on this one, if you check the outside here, it corresponds to this ground. And if you check the inside to this pin, it shows that that's the connection. So it's wired like you would expect it to be wired. And if I just hook that on there, the polarity would be reversed, and I'm sure it'd blow up one of those lithium ion batteries or whatever the heck kind of battery is in there. So I'm gonna have to try to take this circuit and attach it to this plug in the front. All we need is the hot wire and the ground wire, but and hook it onto that with a jumper. And then my other plug, this one, somehow in this reducer circuit board, it converts that, and that should make it work. So all I should have to do is to get a pigtail off of this, cut this thing, and hook it there. Now this did have a fuse in it, and it'd probably be a good idea to get it back in there, and I'll figure that out. But I'll get it wired up and then come back and show you what I've done. Okay, this was a little simpler than I thought, but it's a good thing I checked that polarity, because some kind of way it reverses in this circuit board, like I said earlier, and it would just be a no-go if I would have gotten a conventional one, because the output is different than the input. Don't know why. That's what the little sign said, and it's what turned out to be true. So I snipped off the little spring where the fuse was, and then the ground clip, snipped it off. And so I've got the red as the going to the center plug, and I got the black on this wire going to this white wire, which is your ground on the outside. And I'm going to try to fit it back in this original case and tape it up. And then I got the wires coming out, and that should be no different than what I had, other than this mess looking thing here. But hopefully it's fixed and it'll work, and I'll do a test run and see if it will actually charge up my camera and my viewer. Alright, I'll let you know in a minute. Okay, we're back with the test. I've tried this on the ATV and I wasn't getting any voltage. Took this plug that I wired into it has a fuse, so I checked it. The fuse showed to be good, but I still couldn't get the little green power light to come on the converter. So put it back together, jumped it to a battery, and it showed that it was working. So now I'm up here at my truck and I'm getting 13 volts, got the engine running, plugged it into the viewer, and I get power showing here. And I plugged it into the camera, and you can see the green light, or rather the red light, is the charge. And so they're charging. So I'm going to let it sit here for a little bit and then unplug the camera and be sure it's still working. But also I noticed on the viewer, I don't know what else to call it here, the little screen where you see what's going on. This plug, turn it around maybe, that plug reflects the same thing as the power, and it's showing that the positive is the outside, which is backwards my way of thinking, but somehow that circuit board inside there converts it to 5 volts and then reverses the polarity. And they probably did it for a proprietary reason, so you couldn't just go buy something else, you'd have to buy it from them. But like I say, these people are out of business now. I can't find anything about them. It had a pretty good system and it reverses the image and everything, plus it's got the infrared for darkness. So I don't know. I'm gonna let her charge for a while and then come back and show you what we got going here. Okay, we're back again. I've mounted the camera just temporarily on the bed there, and it was charged a little bit. Now come up here to the viewer, and there you go, there's the fifth wheel, or rather the gooseneck hitch. And of course I wouldn't mount it there to back up, although yeah, I guess you could, but it would be better to get it straight. And this thing also has a microphone on it, so if you've got it mounted back behind a camper or a longer trailer, somebody back yelling don't hit this, don't hit that, or whatever, you could hear them up here. But like I say, this is no longer made. If it is, I sure as heck can't find it. This is called Feel Tough up here, and it was haul safe on the camera. So I guess I took a big problem, and this camera was over $200 I think when I bought it, and because of one little freaking part break, piece of plastic, it rendered the whole thing inoperative. And now you know how to work around. If you ever come across that, just do be sure and read the label and make sure you don't get your polarities replaced or reversed. And there's a wheel and a redneck, there's a way to fix it. Okay, hit that subscribe button, like us and thumbs up and all that good stuff, and Google Plus us and pass us on to your buddies in case they ever run into a problem such as this, or just want to look at some pretty good hunting videos and stuff we found in the mountains. Check out our site, we got all kinds of things, archersfriend.com, and BigKidReviews.com and Archer's Friend on the Tube. Signing off. See you on the next one.